Which is a faster path to financial freedom? Is it pursuing some side business, or is it pursuing real estate investment? I get this question all the time. I'm here in the Maldives today. I'm enjoying my financial freedom. And today I'm gonna break down the difference between business and real estate to help you know which path you should pursue.
One shot, now the future is yours. Go! I'm turning dreams into reality. Yeah, it's one all, one shot, now the future is yours. Go!
So first of all, I think it's a valid question, right? You have a very limited amount of resources. You probably have limited time and you have limited money and you're thinking to yourself, all right, which path should I pursue? If you're a subscriber on my channel, you hear me talk a lot about real estate, but you also hear me talk a lot about business. And so I get this question that comes up. All right, Chris, if you had to do it all over again, like what would be your fastest path towards financial freedom? Would you go back and literally just start buying real estate over and over and over again? Or would you start a side hustle? Would you start a business? Which would you do?
'Cause we're gonna be legends. Gonna get their attention. What we're doing here ain't just scary. It's about to be legendary.
All right, let's start with a couple of definitions on real estate and business ownership according to Investopedia. Basically, it says with real estate, investment real estate is real estate that generates income or is otherwise intended for investment purposes rather than as a primary residence. It's common for investors to own multiple pieces of real estate, one of which serves as a primary residence while the others are used to generate rental income and profits through price appreciation. So in this game of real estate, because it's called an investment, it implies a certain level of passiveness, which means you can buy this asset and it's supposed to work for you rather than you working for it. That passive nature is really important if you're watching this video and you're thinking, Chris, I don't got a lot of time. Like time is a super limited resource. I really need my money to grow for me, or I need to buy assets like real estate that can work for me literally while I sleep so that I'm making money without putting more time into it.
On the other hand, let's take a look at what Investopedia says about business ownership. The term business refers to an organization or enterprising entity engaged in commercial, industrial, or professional activities. Businesses can be for-profit entities or they can be nonprofit organizations that operate to fulfill a charitable mission or further a social cause. Businesses range in scale from sole proprietorships to international corporations. Blah, 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 blah.
Blah, 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 blah.
Investopedia defines business ownership as starting some type of business entity or corporation that's designed to sell a product or a service, so some type of professional service, right? And the idea is you're gonna create and add value for people and you're gonna get paid. And business, this thing, it's gonna require some time. It's considered active as opposed to real estate that is fairly passive. And so as you start weighing these out, we have to do a little bit of a compare and contrast to really understand, okay, one's passive, one's more active. Which one makes me more money? Which one will help me become financially free faster? Let's take a look. All right, I put this nifty little graph together for you to help you understand the big differences between real estate and business and which one you're gonna wanna pursue for producing that extra money, that lifestyle, or that financial freedom. Notice at the top, real estate is listed as passive. We've talked about that. And that's because you basically buy this asset and then it's gonna go to work for you. Business on the other side, it's active, like it's gonna require some time. And it doesn't mean that it's a full-time job. It doesn't mean that, you know, you have to work like 80-hour weeks, but it might need 1, 2, or 3 hours on the side. And within a matter of months, you might be able to literally quit your job and expand that into 3, 4, or 5 more hours. You could make it a full-time thing, or you could keep it really minimal at just a couple hours a day or less and just enjoy more time because you have more money through business. Real estate is less liquid, which basically means you're gonna own this asset, but it's not like you can go to the bank and withdraw a whole bunch of equity immediately. Business, on the other hand, is far more liquid. It's got more cash flow. When you make more money, that money is actually in the bank and it's spendable. On the left side, real estate is where you go for growth. And that basically means, oh, this is an asset. I put in, you know, $5,000, I put in $50,000, and then over time it became $1 million, and then it became $10 million. That's the beautiful thing about real estate. It doesn't require a lot of time. It has a growth curve, and in time you're gonna wake up one day and be like, oh my gosh, like look at all that money.
And look at all the money I'm making.
Woo!
level.
On the other side, if you look at business, you're not really going to it for growth. You're going to it more for that state of cash flow. It's like, well, I put in this time, or I paid people to put in this time, or I have people operating this business, and look at my bank account. There's a lot of money there. And lastly, if you look at real estate, it's gonna require time. Not your personal time in the form of hours, but the passage of time. We say time is our most valuable asset because it's marching on whether you're aware of it or not, whether you're sleeping or whether you're awake. Real estate over years literally has the power to double, triple, quadruple. It just keeps growing. Business, however, it's definitely a faster play if you need more money, more now. Imagine for a moment buying a rental piece of property. It's a single family home. It's something that someone wants to rent and then live in. And let's just say for a moment that your mortgage is $1,100 a month, but that the person is paying you $1,600 a month. That's a $500 a month cash flow. Every single month, more or less, there's going to be $500 extra every month that comes to you. It's predictable, it's a known, and so that's actually a nice thing. Like if I had 10 of those at 500 a piece, that would be $5,000 a month. And again, it would be very consistent. The houses would also appreciate and grow in time. They would provide tax benefits. And so there's something nice that comes from that knowing of this is consistent and this is predictable. On the other hand, that is kind of real estate's downfall. You might be thinking, gee, Chris, what if I want to get to $10,000 a month? I got to buy like 20 homes in that scenario. And maybe I'm forecasting that that will take 3 or 4 years. I get that years from now, that can turn into millions and millions and millions of dollars, but I don't think that I want to wait that long to get that cash flow coming in for the level of mobility and flexibility that I want for my life. Well, then you turn to something like business. Business is now going to need your most precious asset. It's going to need your time. But business is that thing where in a matter of months, or certainly faster than real estate, you could have that extra $5,000 or $10,000 a month. You could have $100,000 a month. You could have $1,000,000 a month if you become really good at that game. And that's what makes these two very, very, very different, is that you have to ask yourself, are you that kind of person that likes the slow and steady wins the race? Or are you thinking, no, Chris, I need something aggressive. I need a change right now. 'Cause we're gonna be legends. Listen, I hope today's video really helped you get clear on whether you should pursue business or real estate. But for me, I actually believe you should be doing not only both of those things, but there's three additional things that you should be doing. I've written a book about it. It's called Have It All. It's the five investments that everyone uses to become a self-made millionaire. You use all five if you want to get there the fastest. So listen, if you like today's video, then be sure to like the video and subscribe. But if you're actually serious about your journey towards wealth, and if it's something where you're like, hey, Chris, 5 years from now, I want to make it. I want to be done. I want to have the wealth. I want to have the millions. I want to have the cash flow. Then I want to unleash the full force of all five strategies for you. In this book, Have It All, there's a link below. You can get a copy of your book for free. Literally just cover the shipping and handling. And I'm going to tell you right now that that book, I believe in today's marketplace for the new economy post-pandemic, I think this is the most powerful financial book written that has the power to deliver on this promise of do these five simple things and just wait. You're going to have the money rolling in. You're going to be able to make the lifestyle choices that you want. I'm here in the Maldives. I'm living it up. I'm having so much fun. You should be doing the same. You should have the same opportunities to travel the world with your loved ones and be able to donate and give to the foundations and charities that really move your heart. You should be able to literally help your family live the life that I know that you really want for them. And so if you want to really make those goals and dreams come true, get a copy of the book, read it. It might be the last financial book you ever need to read to literally set you up financially for that life. Hey, thanks for joining me on today's video. I hope you liked it. Check it out. If you enjoyed learning about business and real estate, the internet believes that you're going to love this video next. Check it out and continue with me on our journey together of awakening your financial genius.
Oh my gosh, did you see that? That was crazy.
I got it.
Oh my God.
I got him.
Wow.